all warp gate, or sorry, all chrono boost has been used on the gateway so far, and or on the Nexus so far, and we actually have an assimilator coming out, so, or sorry, a second assimilator. A little bit of a tech heavy play here. We'll have to see exactly what this turns into. We do have a bunker coming up for intense. That stalker is going to get there way after the bunker completes, so intense should have one, maybe two marines in it, able to deny that stalker. And actually going up to four barracks here without taking a gas, so definitely probably going to see a little bit of pressure out of intense. Defensively, you can survive off of three barracks against most anything, actually. So very interesting choice there. We'll see how that transitions also. And the second gas up for our Protoss player, you know, I'm not sure what this is going to be quite yet. We do have a sentry out now after the stalker. And a probe here also. And oh my goodness, losing that probe to that bunker very early. Got shot as it was coming up the ramp. And it looks like Intense is going to play this super safe and actually take a second bunker, as he has not scouted his opponent yet, has no idea what's coming. And yeah, I mean, look, this is the timing for a four gate, so Intense being very careful here. Seeing the expansion now. And we'll see if he cancels this bunker or salvages it or what he decides to do. He may even keep it. But oh my goodness, we have a bunker coming up at the natural for the Protoss. And let's see if Intense sends any marines. This is kind of odd if he's not going to send the marines. Perhaps just make him try to pull some probes or something. Alright, so the two bunkers are done for Intense here. Four racks are complete. Still no gas. Definitely interesting. Two sentries for our Protoss player. Does he still not see this bunker? Yeah, he does see it. I don't know what he's thinking here, actually. Trying to chase that SCV around. Oh, the bunker didn't complete. Sorry. Looking at it through the fog of war. And, it's one stalker. He can do what he can. But actually, this bunker forced the Protoss player to pull back. And look at all these marines coming across. I don't think the Protoss player has any idea this is coming. But the three warp gates have finished. Oh, this is a good number of marines. He could do some damage here. We're going to need good force fields out of the Protoss. And actually losing two of his sentries before even putting down a force field. That is, like, the biggest deal I have seen all game. Wow. The sentries are there specifically for that purpose. To make sure the Terran doesn't do damage. And he lost not only most of his gas, but... Oh, that was just a huge mistake, it seems. We do have a Forge and a Twilight Council coming down for him, so his tech is definitely going to be further ahead, as Intense is just now taking both of his gases at his main. But look how many Marines are out here, man. There's only two sentries and a Stalker, and this Nexus is actually going to go down. This is a huge deal. Protoss player going for a one-gate expansion off of two gas and loses his Nexus. Oh, it hurts to see. Actually losing another sentry and one of many GGs right out right away. So Intense taking a very quick lead there and just pummeling his opponent right away. A couple of big mistakes from one of many. Those sentries really could have trapped a lot of the Marines inside and not lost any of the sentries. Could have pulled a few probes to help defend. But yeah, really just dying right away. So small mistake paying off big time for Intense. In game number two here, very, very surprising. So that was a very fast game. It looks like we're going to be back here with game three in just a couple of minutes. Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm shocked. We'll be right back.
Oh, great. Send him in.
Hey, guys.
Hey. Hi. Thanks for coming.
Sorry I'm late. I just got caught up watching the Pirates of the Caribbean marathon. Have you seen those things?
Oh, yeah, those are great.
Well, I checked out the track, and I loved it, and I wrote you this big, sexy book that you can really dig.
Oh, wow, that's great. Awesome. Should we just lay it down?
Boys, let's get to it.
Here we go. Snapping at the neck when we rolling up. Blow through the doors, ain't no holding up. Black card at the bar like I gives a fuck.
Let me shoot the eye when we walk into the set. Fuck the fellas looking jealous, play the back and get wet. 3 pounds in my waist, shank in my sock. You either get cut, get stuffed, or get shot.
This is the tale of
Rappers love. Motherfucking Iceman, I'm the top gunner. Heater on blast, I'm the number one stunner.
Watch your girl, cause I ain't your Mr. Nice Guy. More like the meet you, take you home and fuck you twice, guy. All dressed up with nowhere to run. I know I make you feel crazy.
Now back to the good part.
Hell yeah, come on.
Captain Jack.
What?
Johnny Depp.
No.
From the front to the back, say we count stacks. Come on.
David Jones. Yep. Giant Squid.
Oh. Michael Bolton, we're really gonna need you to focus up.
Roger that, let me try with another film.
Wait.
Life is a box of chocolates and my name is Forrest Gump.
Not better.
Though I'm not the sharpest tool in the shed, I give Jenny all my love.
Come on.
Okay, then I'm a legal aid. Aaron Brockovich is my name.
Oh, God.
And you can cockroaches wanna play rough. Okay, I'm reloaded.
Psych.
Chris,
my brother, what is up?
Nothing much, just chilling.
Oh, that's
my Alienware games, pretty easy.
Oh, that's good. That's good. I heard you played a really difficult opponent.
Yeah, Gold Terran's pretty good.
Yeah. All right. So, damn, overlay switchings. All right. We do have on the bottom of Shattered Temple a second time from the team SCA, Draz.
And on the left side of Shattered Temple, we have aiR Intense, who I heard is on a tear right now. Two guys out already, so.
Yeah, man.
Good job to him.
Yeah. Really good first game, really fast second game. Pretty interesting pressure. I'm not sure if he, you know, builds that bunker regularly to pull that stalker back, but it worked, I think, phenomenally is an understatement here.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Doing a great job with the bat, obviously. Is this the first TBT? I think it is, because you played TBZ, TBP?
Yes, sir.
So this is the first TBT, and Terran is my specialty. As I play the race. Speciality, indeed. So, double Terran, so I should know what's going on. Should. Doesn't mean I do.
Hopefully.
Hopefully I do. So, looks like Intense is going to be getting a standard Rax timing here. Not walling off. Looks like he's just going to leave that Spidey Blue Dare. Maybe make a bunker, but Draz is doing exactly the same thing. Sorry.
Dude, these barracks are like almost in the exact same location. Look at that.
Yeah,
it's like the same number of X's away from the ramp and the command center here.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty
Gases
incredible.
Are both close on the same side. What the fuck?
How funny would it be if Intense was just like, you know, they had a program and it would mirror himself. This is going to be so cool. Let's see how long we can keep this up for. Alright, so.
God, probably not.
Well, yeah, Andraz scouted like way, way, way earlier than Intense here.
Yeah, pretty much.
Scouting for that proxy at the gold, definitely making sure that it's, he's not
actually, you got it backwards. That's Draz, bro.
Oh my! Save me. Alright, you're right. You win.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so Intense was the one that scouted early. Yeah, and Draz wasn't the one that, scouted early.
Let's
so.
Start over. Can we do a redo?
Go for it.
Alright, so we do have Draz only mining two guys on gas right now, actually. Is this indicative of anything?
Reaper?
Alright.
Because you don't need much gas. That'd be my main guess, and yeah, there you go, Reaper. Just because he had the tech lab there. So, Intense does have three on gas. Looks like he's going to be throwing down that factory. So, maybe a siege tank, Marine all in, maybe Cloak Banshee. We'll see. Looks like two gas, so probably Cloak Banshee, especially close air is very good. And TBT, you're never really behind with Cloak Banshee, but right now Intense does not have those Marines on the ledge. He didn't really, he's not playing super, super safe. So that Reaper can potentially do some damage to the Mineral Line and maybe even stall that factory building or something.
You know,
actually, start Starport building.
I heard you're a big fan of playing against Cloak Banshee, West Terran.
Yeah, it's pretty easy, you know. I really hate it. It sucks, man. It's a good build. But yeah, it looks like the Reaper's going to get in here, stall the building on that starport just a bit. That's just going to slow him down even more and kill a couple of SCVs on gas. So, yeah, the Reaper just going to scout around. He does see two gas. He does see that starport almost gets us around very close. But, yeah, his guess right now is probably Cloak Banshee, so, which would be a great guess because it looks like it's going to be Cloak Banshee. Or just regular Banshee. One of the two is going to be it. So.
It does look like that. Something I do want to point out is that the SCVs on gas got targeted, and actually Intense has not replaced that yet, so maybe didn't notice that it got killed, but definitely very important to target guys on gas if you're going to target SCVs with a non-splash damage unit or, you know, whatever like that.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, this could really affect the outcome of the game, especially when he's going, looks like Cloak Banshee.
Yeah, definitely. I guess he was trying to go Cloak Banshee, but with that, you're right. Like you said, there's two guys on gas. Like, it stalled his mining gas so much, and he doesn't have enough gas to actually build Cloak right now. So maybe if it was his plan that got stalled and he just decided to go for Siege Sink now, I'm not sure what he was thinking, but it looks like that it's going to work out okay.
Something else to note is I really don't like that Draz continued to make Reapers. I mean, he made two more Reapers after what, I mean, it wasn't obviously Cloak Banshee, but you see two gas and you got to assume Banshee is a possibility here, right? I mean, he's not going to have very many Marines at all to defend this Banshee. Right now he's got five on the field. He's got three racks, so that's going to help, but only one turret. I don't know, man. I don't like that decision.
Yeah, I definitely don't either, especially if you scout that, like you said. It's really, really risky to do that. I guess he's just going for map control purposes. And if you look on the main, these two Reapers are actually getting a ton of SCV kills, more than they actually should at this point in the game. So, pretty decent call, I guess. I mean, the Banshee... Oh, got shot by the turret. Okay. Wow. That was a huge blunder by Intense, actually. That should never, ever happen.
Yeah, that was actually exactly when Intense was looking back at the Reapers, so...
Because
he had it like on the hockey, ready to go, didn't die.
Yeah, but I still think Intense is looking good just because of all the production he has right now. He's two siege tanks and actually more Marines than Draz has, so that's not good at all. So Draz needs to make something happen here. He just neglected to make those two reactors on those barracks, so he's going to have Marine production that's not ideal at all. And so this all-in coming right now should be really, really effective. I'd like to see what happens here.
Yeah, but, Siege Mode not going to be done when he gets there to start, is it?
No, it's not. He's going to try and kill off these Marines here and try to get map control. It's going to be delayed a bit. I guess he's just going to wait for it, but, I mean, he still has about 30 seconds to go on that, so... we'll see what happens.
Interesting. Very fast combat shield. Is that to counter the Banshees a little bit from Dresd?
Combat shield? Yeah, I guess it's okay.
But it gives you the extra hit against Banshees, right?
Yeah, it does. Yeah, but Stim, you can kill it faster, or you can actually kill it because Stim Marines outrun a Banshee. So it's trading that for that. But combat shield, it is done. So it's going to help a lot versus these tanks. But I don't know if he has enough Marines, especially without Stim. His DPS is going to be a lot lower than you'd expect it to be. So this is looking pretty good by Intense.
Yeah, he's going to pick off this turret, and you know. Probably going to have the Banshees come up and try to support this a little bit. Definitely is. And, taking a lot of damage, but he does have all those SCVs up there to try to help repair, I would assume.
Banshee's getting a little low, but he is macroing very well and going to get a lot of kills. Banshees do outrange Marines by one, so if he macros perfectly, he can snipe Marines. Not moving the siege tanks up, and actually he's giving Draz a lot of time to get a siege tank out of himself. Not siege, just regular tank, but he just gets sniped immediately, so ignore that, basically. But yeah, it looks like Intense is actually taking this game pretty easily right now.
Yeah, supply's currently 40. Well, they're dropping rapidly for Draz, and actually they're dropping pretty rapidly for Intense, but Intense definitely way in the lead here, probably going to get this expansion really easily, if not completely end the game right here.
Yeah, this looks like it will be game. It's 34 supply to 52. He does not have siege tanks out, so it's going to be much harder to even hold anything. A ton of Marines. Intense has way more Marines than Draz does. So it looks like...